BBC introducing
in Hereford and Worcester.
So this next artist is a 23-year-old singer-songwriter. He owns his own barber shop here in Droitwich, and he's just gone and finished his debut EP. His passion is music, and he's been gigging a lot in the local area. He's been writing songs since he's 14. Put your hands together, Richard Farmer.
Hello.
Walking down this beaten track, I still want you back, I still need you back. If I don't try, I guess I'll never know. I won't win your heart, and I'll be all alone. If I don't try, I guess I'll never know. I just can't let go. I just can't let go. You're running high, but I can't see you to find. Seem to find it. You're running high to a place I'm. Try my best to pass the time, but it's not all fine. I just need a sign. The counting reasons that I need to go. After all I know, I just can't let go. Seems like every time you're running high, it's like you're running. At all.
can't seem to find you at all.
Thank you. That's the only depressing one, I promise.
Farmer. More from him in a bit, but first we're just sitting right now in the sort of beer garden, soaking up the rays, beautiful June day. You're from Droitwich, aren't you?
Yes, I am, yeah.
What's your experience of the Droitwich Festival?
Yeah, I kind of go to every year. It's a really nice festival that Droitwich put on, to be honest with you. It's my first year actually doing anything to do with music.
So you've just performed for us, and you've been performing for almost 10 years now, since you were 14, 15. When did you realise you could sing like this?
I kind of realised when I was at school when there's kind of a variety show on, and me and my friend decided that we wanted to do something, so I kind of gave it a go, and the reaction went down quite well, and I've kind of got the bug ever since.
Have the teacher's arms in the air and everything.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, they were quite shocked, to be honest. Yeah, then it was kind of always sung since I was young, but then when people kind of give the reaction to you singing and stuff like that, it kind of like spurs you on to kind of carry on to do it.
So recently you've released your first EP, kind of a step up I'd say for you. What was it like to get hold of that big box of CDs and see your finished EP?
Yeah, it's quite exciting to be honest with you, because I mean, I've been writing music for a long time now, and it was only kind of recently where I've had the financial position to be able to fund getting recorded in studio time and things like that. So yeah, it's a lot of work over the last 12 months getting the EP actually finished, you know, narrowing down all the songs. So when you actually saw the finished product, yeah, it was amazing.
Let's talk about the recording of the Evermore EP. Was it local? Who helped you produce it? Did you do it yourself?
It's a great young producer called Ben Stankham who produced it for me, and he's...
We know that name on this show, yeah. Yeah.
Quite a good friend of mine. He lives in Bromsgrove and it's just a home run studio, but yeah, it's absolutely brilliant.
So your EP, especially I Can't Fly, for me, it's chilled, it's almost haunting and quite indie, but there's also a lead on your EP in other tracks such as Shy Girl. It's more of an R&B feel. Like, what would you say your music is for people?
I wanted to kind of create like quite a diverse range of genres on the EP. For me personally, when I kind of listen to, you know, an album or an EP, I hate kind of every song kind of sounds the same. So when me and Ben sat down and said like, how are we going to do it? We wanted to make every single song kind of sound like their own track and their own song.
You've also done quite a few covers on your SoundCloud pages, like Adele, Michael Bublé, most recently Kaiser. Are these the sort of artists that influence you musically, or who do you sort of cite as your inspiration?
I like taking modern tracks, you know, like house music, and that kind of putting your own acoustic twist on it.
And also, I Spy on your wrist, if you just lift it up for me. Other one, that's your watch. This one. So you've been to a festival recently, where have you been?
Into Parklife. Yeah, it was absolutely brilliant. I saw Sam Smith. Yeah, it was great.
Could you imagine yourself being at the stature of Sam Smith and the success he's had this year at one point in the future?
I'd hope so, but you know, it's a dream, isn't it?
Back to the music writing process, what comes first for you? Is it the lyrics or is it the music?
I think it's kind of different with every song you kind of write. I mean, some songs it's kind of the music come first, some songs it's the lyrics. One song, for example, it's kind of just driving, and then the hook kind of came to me and I just got my phone out, recorded that little bit.
Tell us about your day job as well. I heard it's quite different to music.
It is, yeah. I own a barber shop on the Droitwich High Street. I've been a barber for about 7-8 years now, and I just recently got my own shop about a year ago.
No barbershop music as such, though?
No, definitely not. Not a barbershop music.
More of an R&B feel.
That's
from
it.
You. What would you say is your long-term goal with your music? Where would you want to be?
I mean, I just really enjoy writing my own music. That's enough for me anyway. But I mean, obviously, it's every artist's dream to actually make it in the music industry and be taken seriously. So, I mean, yeah, fingers crossed for that.
Do you ever sing for your clients?
I don't know. I don't sing for my clients. Quite a lot of my clients downloaded the EP and bought the CD and stuff like that. I mean, the CD's available to buy in the shop as well, so you get quite a lot of customers kind of buy it and stuff, and they come back in and they're like, oh, really good, you know, they really enjoyed it, and it goes down quite well, yeah.
Richard Farmer, thank you very much for joining us at the Cut Hour as part of the Droitwich Festival, and all the best. Stay in touch.
Thank you very much.
BBC introducing In Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Marston.
Be part of it.
Till I can find out the truth. Everything and everyone's got their youth. But I can run, but I can run after you. I can learn to love, but I can't refuse. Thank you.
every night I'll see you back with me. Just give it back the way I see, 'cause you're gone when I need. I'll be here when you're gone evermore. And I'm running out of time, and I'm feeling for the first time the way I feel evermore. Just give it back the way I see, 'cause you're gone when I need. I'll be here when you're gone evermore. And I'm running, I'm running out of time, and I'm feeling for the first time the way I feel evermore. And I'm running out of time, and I'm feeling for the first time the way I feel evermore. Evermore. And and I'm running out of time, and I'm feeling for the first time the way I feel evermore, and I'm running, and I'm running out of time, and I'm feeling for the first time the way I feel evermore, and I'm running, and I'm running out of time, I'm feeling for the first time the way I feel evermore.
There we go, performing live here at the Droitwich Spa Festival, Richard Farmer.
BBC introducing In Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Master.
Right, no pressure, because I know you're sitting opposite him, but what do you make of Richard Farmer in our BBC introducing session?
I think he's unbelievable, very good.
I think he's great, really good. You can go far. Evermore for me, that's my favourite song of his.
My name's Danielle, what's your name?
Kieran.
Kieran, and have you just listened to the man singing? Yeah, did you like it or did you not like it?
Like it.
You liked it. What's your name?
Josh.
And what do you make of Richard's performance?
Very lovely.
Have you seen him before?
I have, yes.
Is that because he's your friend?
Indeed.
But you like his music anyway?
I do very much, yes.
Best gig?
Yeah, what music are you into?
Drake. Went to Drake last year, yeah.
Best gig ever?
Yeah, I'd probably say Drake is, to be fair. The best one I've been to. I've only been to a couple.
What's the best gig you've been to?
Parklife Festival was best for me, I think.
Right, who'd you see there?
Sam Smith, Second City, Fame Within, DJ EZ, Disclosure, a few others.
Could you see Richard up there one day?
Hopefully.
Okay then. Becky and Trevor Babajack. Now normally we see you guys up there doing your thing, but today you've got a rare opportunity to sit back, have a pint at the Copcut at Elm, and you've just watched Richard Farmer. What did you make of him?
The guy's got a great voice. I can see what he's doing, trying to do that kind of Coldplay kind of thing. Yeah, good on him.
Listen to the best interviews online.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford
and Worcester
/introducing.